The executive group has implemented a temporary pause of the hydroxychloroquine arm within the Solidarity trial while the safety data is reviewed. As part of our continued response to the pandemic globally, WHO continues to work aggressively on research and development. As you know, more than 2 months ago, we initiated the Solidarity trial to evaluate the safety and efficacy of 4 drugs and drug combinations against COVID-19. Over 400 hospitals in 35 countries are actively recruiting patients, and nearly 3,500 patients have been enrolled from 17 countries. On Friday, The Lancet, as you know, published an observational study on hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine and its effects on COVID-19 patients that have been hospitalized. The authors reported that among patients receiving the drug, when used alone or with a macrolide, they estimated a higher mortality rate. The executive group of the Solidarity trial, representing 10 of the participating countries, met on Saturday and has agreed to review a comprehensive analysis and critical appraisal of all evidence available globally. The review will consider data collected so far in the Solidarity trial, and in particular, robust randomized available data to adequately evaluate the potential benefits and harms from this drug. The executive group has implemented a temporary pause of the hydroxychloroquine arm within the Solidarity trial while the safety data is reviewed by the Data Safety Monitoring Board. The other arms of the trial are continuing. This concern relates to the use of hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine in COVID-19. I wish to reiterate that these drugs are accepted as generally safe for use in patients with autoimmune diseases or malaria.